Hello friends, this video is specially for those who have not used Canva to create designs. It's a very simple online platform. I'll show you step by step how to create your design. So after you practice it for a couple of days, you'll be able to create your designs in just about 5 minutes. So here we go. You type canva.com, canva.com. If you are using a mobile and if you want to try it on your laptop, I think that will be a great idea. So on your laptop or on your PC, you can open that particular website, canva.com. Now, when you go to that, I have already logged in actually. So if you are a first time user, you have to log in. You can also use your Google account to log in or Facebook account to log in. Or you can have a special, you can create your own account in Canva. It's a very, very useful software, piece of software. And I'm sure you will love this. So right now, what you see on the screen is the homepage of Canva. So on the left hand side, you can see my name, then I can add my picture also, which I have not done so far. Then I can straight away start creating a design. So when I click on create a design, it will give me a lot of options. In fact, the same thing you can see here also on the screen, create a design. So whether you want to design a YouTube thumbnail, a Facebook post, Instagram post, you don't have to worry about the size and length and width, everything, because it automatically it will take desktop wallpaper or social media posts, Facebook story, presentation, these and that. So hundreds of things, right? So from these things, you can decide any, or you can create your own design using your own, you can give your own dimensions. So, that's one thing. Another is, because I have created a lot of designs, so all my designs are here. So when I click on this, all your designs, you will see all the designs that I have created so far, hundreds. Okay. Then you can see templates. Hundreds of templates are available, as I showed you a couple of them in the beginning, So there are so many. For Facebook posts also, there are hundreds of templates. You can straight away take any of these and you can change a little bit here and there and you can have your own design. All these are ready-made templates and you can change the color, the text, everything. Then we have a lot of photos. If you want to use any photo in your design, most of them are free. And some of them, if you want to buy, you can buy and use them. And otherwise, hundreds are free, thousands in fact. Then there are some apps, then these things are not really required for you. If you want, you can create your folder, you can create a team so you can work together with your team members. But right now we'll go for the basics. So let's create a design. So I'll click on create a design. So as I mentioned, I can give custom dimensions, or I can take any ready-made formats. For example, let's go for an Instagram post or a Facebook post. Let's go for a Facebook post. So when I click on that, automatically Canva will take the size, length and breadth, length and width that is required for the Facebook post. So now this is a blank page for me. I can use this. I can give the, you know, background color. For example, here you can see the background color. So I can select any of these colors, this color, this color, this. Or if I want some pattern, then I can use one of these. And when you take your cursor on a particular design, it will tell you whether it is free or not. So for example, if I take this, so this will look like this. And suppose I feel plain color, I don't want any design, but I'm not happy with the colors given here, then no worries. You can go to the first item on the palette. You can select, you can make your own color actually. So you can go to this particular place and you can decide what particular color you want. You can move your cursor and decide. Say for example, if I light a little dark green background, then this. And if I want a very light sky color kind of background, so it will be this. So let's go for this. Okay, so I have selected my background. Then if I have, if I want to use any photos, I can use that. Let's see if there is a good flower. Let me search F-L-O-W-E-R, flower. If I get a good flower, I'll put it there. Oh, wonderful. This is my favorite color, pink. But it's a pro version, so it's a paid, so I will not take that. This one is free. So let me take this, just to show you how it is. So when you click on that, that flower comes here, right? So fine, it is here. I can take it anywhere, wherever I want. I can select with control. I have pressed my control button. So control and then just drag it. Suppose I feel it is too big, so I can make it smaller also. If I feel I don't need these many leaves here, so I can use this. If I take this, it will be a smaller or bigger, right? But if I take this particular part, the horizontal dash kind of thing, then the picture is cut. You can see that. Okay. So for example, I don't want this leaves. I just want this flower. But it looks a little awkward, so let me go for some more. Yeah, I think this is fine. So here I have some leaves. Anyway, let me take some more. So some leaves and some flowers. That's perfect. Now, if you want to look for a particular thing, you can search here. For example, if I want a girl, a little girl. And if there is a photo, I can take. So this is a photograph of a girl. I can take that, click here. So it has come here. It's too big, so I'll make it a little smaller. Fine. Yeah. Now, suppose I feel it is too dark. So I can, using this transparency, I can make it lighter, right? So you can see the impact on the photo. So right now I kept it 100, no problem, but I can change it whenever I want. Okay, so I've taken a photo. Then here we have some elements like geometrical figures like square and oval shape. So they're all available. You can take any. For example, I like this one. So I click on that and here I can drag and put wherever I want. Okay, but I'm not happy with the color. So what I'll do? I can see this color here on the top. Okay, if you are somewhere outside, you can click on that. So that box will appear on the top. So you can click on that. And again, you have the same palette. So you can decide what color you want. For example, I like, say, red. Fine, perfect. So I put red here. Now I feel that there is, I want a square around this particular what is it called? Hexagon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. So around that I want to put a square. So I can take a square, but this time I want a different type of square, not with the color inside, but I'll take it just the boundary. Okay. So I've taken this square and I want to put it around it. Okay, fine. So now my square is around that. Now when I see the color of this border is red, if I want to change it, I can change it. For example, from here, I can change the border to say black. Let's see. Yeah, when you click outside, you will see, yeah, see? Now the border is black of that square, right? Now, suppose I want to write something somewhere. So I'll take the text and these are some ready-made options. You can select any of these, whatever font you like. In fact, you can randomly also take any and later you can change it. So for example, let's take this one. It's free. Make sure that it is free. Otherwise, you have to, when you save it, you will be asked to pay. So I have taken this free template. Yeah, this is the free version. In fact, you can use cursor, like up and down arrows also to place your text or image at a proper place. So right now I'm using up and down arrows, okay? Right. Or you can drag and drop also, both are one and the same. Yeah, you can drag and drop. Now you can see here, there are two boxes and they both are connected. Because the person who created that, he put it like that. But I don't want like that, so I can separate them. So for that, I can go to ungroup. So when it is selected, when I ungroup it, now all the boxes are separate. Now I can change, I can move only this part also. Earlier, both were moving together. Now only one part is moving, right? And suppose I feel the font is not okay, so I can change that font from here on the top. You say I like Horizon, put that. Oh, it's too big. So what I can do, I can make it smaller. I can make it say 24. Yeah, let's see. Yeah, 32, maybe a little bigger. So love and joy. Yeah, it's a good caption. Now, if I want to tell people who the person is, so I can say, I have created this. So my name, Dharmendra Sheth. Now, suppose I don't like any of these ready-made formats, then I can go to regular text also. So big font, dark, a little softer, smaller. So I can select that and then I can write here, say anything, say the name of my institute. Yeah. And I can make it bigger, smaller, whenever I want. Okay. Now I can make it a little broader so my fluent lingua comes properly. Okay. Now suppose I want to add some music. So you can add music. If you want to add some videos, you can add that also. When you click on music, lots of music, ready-made music will come. Some of them are free, some of them they may be paid, right? You have to check it when you select it. Okay, so you can add some videos. Now, suppose you feel that I don't want to take anything available here ready-made. I want to have my own JPG file, my own picture here. So no worries, you can go to this left-hand side bottom upload feature. So you can go to upload, you can upload your image. For example, here I can try uploading one of my recent images. Okay, I can upload, for example, let me see if I have a tiger. No, I don't have a tiger, is that so? I doubt that. Yeah, I have a tiger. See, there are so many tigers. So for example, if I take this tiger, so this tiger is uploaded onto Canva platform. So from that, see now it has come, it is uploaded. So when I select, when I click this, automatically it comes on my workplace, workstation or work area, whatever you call it. So this is my tiger. I can make it big, small, whatever I want. Okay, I can move it wherever I want. So let me put it here. Oh, maybe on the top. That girl is looking at the tiger, no worries. Yeah. Okay. Little tiger, behave yourself. Yeah. Okay, so I have a tiger. I think the tiger likes an apple, so I can give it. Anyway. So suppose you want to take an image from the internet, no worries, you can go to the internet, you can select any free image software. For example, I go for Pixabay, one of my favorite ones. So when I go to pixabay.com and see, last time we took a girl, so let's take a boy. right? Let's take a boy and see what images are available. Hey, some of them are so cute. Yeah, I like this boy. Microphone boy. Or this one. This one looks like my son, Hardik, when he was a child. So let me select this. Okay. And I will free download, you can see here. Right, it is free download. So I will select that. And I can select what size. Right now I can take any, it doesn't matter. So I have taken this particular download. Okay. Now, because I am a registered user, I can download straight away. If you are not a registered user of Pixabay, you can register, no problem. Or you can use Google or Facebook account to register, no worries. Now I am downloading, right? And it is always better to give credit to a person. So there is a link which you can click. Anyway, I am sharing it. I am saving it up, downloading it. Boy from Pixabay. Why I'm writing boy from Pixabay? Because I have lots of boys in my folder, so I don't want to get confused later. So this I have saved in my folder, right, where I keep my all JPG files. And now again I go to my workplace, okay, workstation or work area, and I can again go to upload. And from my computer, I'll find out where I have saved that. So from search, I can find out boy from Pixabay. I think it is enough. Yeah, boy from Pixabay. Okay, you can see so many boys I have. So it is good that I wrote boy from Pixabay. So when I select that, open that, it comes to my folder on in Canva. So once it is up, right now it is uploading. So once it is done, I'll be able to click this. Yeah, it is done now. So I can click this and I can take that boy, wonderful boy, lovely, cute boy, and put it wherever I want. Maybe I can put it here. Yes, fine. Now you can see my other things are not visible. So I have to make this boy a little smaller. Yeah. Better now. And now I feel that I can keep this Fluent Lingua, the name of my company, somewhere else. So maybe I can drag it and put it here. Okay. And there was something else. I can delete that. See, if I don't like, I can delete that. So now I have this Fluent Lingua. Let me make it smaller so that it is visible. Right. And I would like to remove this. Why? Because I already have my wonderful image here of my institute, my company. I already uploaded, so I can use that. Right? Cool. So now people can know, yes, this is my logo, Fluent Lingua. Right? I can remove also this, it's not required. Right? So this is my image ready. If I want to make it still better, I can do some tweaking here and there. I can make it bigger, maybe. Yeah, I can now remove this in such a fashion that both are of the same size. Oh, my name is still there in the background, so I can remove that. Okay. So I think we have covered all the important features, right? Now, I have not given the name. It's here on the top. You can give the name. Okay, what can I say? Canva tutorial. Canva tutorial for beginners. Fine. So I have saved that. Actually, you don't have to save it. It is automatically saved. Suppose power supply goes now. No worries. Everything is already saved. Every second Canva keeps saving, right? It's wonderful. Since we have some children, let's keep some children also. Anyway, so you can do 1,000 things with this particular design. You can change font, color, everything. Now, suppose everything is over. You want to download that. Ultimately, you will have to download and then only you can use it somewhere. So You can in fact publish directly to Facebook or other platforms if you are already logged in with that. Otherwise, you can download in your own computer. So here, there is a download icon. You can click on that. And normally, it is available in PNG format. In other formats, you have to pay, right? So even for high quality, I suggest take PNG, because wherever JPG is used, PNG can always be used. It is not the other way around. So I always prefer PNG images. So here I am saving PNG. It will ask me where to save. So I will save my Canva informal tutorial for beginners. So it is saved in my same folder, right? And then, yeah, that's done now, right? Now suppose you want to create another image with changing a little bit here and there in this design. So you don't have to start from scratch. What you can do is you can go to File and you can make a copy. So when you make a copy, a new window opens and the title of that window is, you can see the file name has seen, copy of the earlier version, right? So what we can do here, we can give Canva trial 2, right? Now, for example, I don't like this tiger, so I can remove that tiger. Come on, tiger, go, go, go. Why is it not going? Come on, yeah, it has gone now. Suppose let me remove everything here. And then start fresh with, say, some ready-made format. Say, let's take this one. Yeah. So it has come automatically. I haven't done anything. This ready-made, whatever was available, I have taken. And here I would like to write my name. So I will write Ravindra Sheth. So whatever was the original format, it takes that and it takes all the details accordingly, right? Now, if I say my bicycle, right? And suppose I feel that this original font size is too small, no worries, I can make it bigger, 24, right? And I can ungroup it, so I can make this particular box bigger so that certain parts don't go to the next line. I can make it up to this. I can take it up to this. I can put it in the center, for example, left, justify, right, and center. All the features are available. Normal features, right? So automatically it is saved also. Now suppose I don't like the background, I can add some other background, say this background. Lots of love. Yeah, you can see the background has seen now clouds and loves and so many things have come. But if I feel that this background is too dark, I can make it lighter. See? Now, can't you create your design in 5 minutes? So easy. Right? So this was a sample. You can again save it if you want, or you can publish it directly anywhere you like. So I guess you have understood now how to do what is Canva. And when you're finished, you can just log out or you can just close it, no worries. Everything is saved. So this is what I wanted you to see. Thank you. These are my teachers, if you can see on the screen. Dr. Sudhakar Marathe and Mrs. Marathe. So if you have any questions, you can ask me. Let me actually write my number. How can I show? Maybe let me go to my original folder. I can show you one of my designs. Or maybe in pictures, I already have my visiting card probably, so that will be good enough, right? So if I make it bigger, you can see it. So if you have any question, you can always ask me anytime. Just send me a WhatsApp message. My number you can see on the screen. it will take a minute to download. Not a minute, less than a minute, don't worry. So once it is downloaded, I don't know why it is taking such a lot of time. Normally it doesn't. So the name of my institute is Fluent Lingua. Many people ask me, why do you call it Fluent Lingua? So basically, lingua is a Latin-based word, which means tongue. So as you know, our mother tongue, right, is our first language. So tongue is related to language, basically. And then we have the other word, fluent. Now, as you know, fluency, ability to speak without any unnecessary pauses, that is your fluency. Okay, so now you can see on the screen my visiting card. When I opened it, now it has opened. So you can contact me on this number. You can email me fluentlingua@gmail.com, or you can send me a WhatsApp message on this one, 98254-42418. So thank you very much for this particular session. Enjoy designing. Enjoy creating your own designs. Thank you very much.